thought we'd have another story today, and this is one of the stories from my daughter's favourite storybook when she was young, a fairy tales book. And she particularly liked this fairy tale. And it's the story of Rumpelstiltskin. This poor miller has a very clever daughter. He boasts about her. "Sire, my daughter is so clever that she can even spin straw into gold," he tells the king. The king takes the daughter to his palace. He shows her a room with some straw and a spinning wheel. "Spin it into gold by morning, or you'll die," he says. The daughter sits down and cries. She can't spin straw into gold. Then a little man comes in. "What will you give me if I spin it for you?" he asks. "I'll give you my necklace," she says. The little man spins away all night. By morning, he has spun all the straw into gold thread. Then he disappears. The king is very pleased with the gold. He shows the daughter another room with more straw. "Spin that into gold by morning, or you'll die," he says. Soon the little man comes in. "What will you give me if I spin this bigger pile of straw into gold for you?" he asks. "My ring," says the daughter. In the morning the king comes in. The little man has spun all the straw into gold. The king is very pleased, but he's greedy and he wants more gold. He takes the daughter to a bigger room. "There's a bigger pile of straw. Spin it all by morning, or you'll die," he says. Soon the little man comes in. "What will you give me now?" he asks. "I've nothing left," says the daughter. "Promise to give me your first baby when you're queen," says the little man. In the morning, the king is delighted. "Marry me, and we'll always be rich," he says. Soon there's a royal wedding, and the daughter is the queen. The queen is very happy when her first baby is born. Then the little man comes. "If you can't guess my name in 3 days, I'll take your baby away," he says. The queen thinks of names all day and all night. When the little man comes the next day, she says, "Is it Tom, John, or Henry?" The little man says, "No, you're wrong." The little man comes again the next day. "Is it Bandylegs, Crooksy, or Boggles?" asks the queen. "No. One more try and I'll take the baby," says the little man. The next day a messenger comes to the queen. "I saw a little man in the woods. He was singing, 'My name is Rumpelstiltskin,'" he says. "Thank you," says the queen. "Your name is Rumpelstiltskin," says the queen. The little man is very angry. He stamps the floor so hard, his foot goes through the floor, then he disappears forever. very nice little man, was he? But good that that man, the other man, helped the Queen by finding out his name. It all ended, they all lived happily ever after. Bye.